Good morning, children. In today's session, I'm going to give you book back answers in English for 7th standard. In poem, Your Space. In previous class, I gave question answers in prose book back. Now I'm going to give poem question answers, okay? Your Space. Those who have the book can take page number 157. And those who are not having the book, take down in your notebook, neatly in your book, children, and so that you can learn easily. So now we'll see answer the following poem, Your Space. Answer the following. So what is the first question? Why should we speak gently? Why should we speak gently? So this is the first question for you. So the answer is, we should speak gently because soft and kind words leave a deep and lasting impression. We can win people's hearts by love, and God too likes it and reward us for eternity. So this is the first answer, children, for you. Okay, once again I'll read it. Why should we speak gently? We should speak gently because soft and kind words leave a deep and lasting impression. Deep and lasting impression. We can win people's hearts by love, and God too likes it. And reward us for eternity. So once again, I'll read, children. So when I'm reading, read along with me, children. It's so that it can be easy for you all. So again and again, I'm saying this only for you all. So when I'm reading, read it along with me. Why should we speak gently? We should speak gently because soft and kind words leave a deep and lasting impression. We can win people hearts by love, and God too likes it and reward us for eternity. Now we are going to see the second question. What's the second question? What do you infer about speaking with others from this poem. So what is the question, children? What do you infer about speaking with others from this lesson? So From this poem we understand, we understand that at all levels, that at all levels, that at all levels there is problems, there is problems and sadness, there is problems and there is problems and sadness to everyone, to everyone, but with kind and with kind and gentle words, kind and with kind and gentle words they can be overcome, they can be overcome. Okay children, so this is answer for the second one. So what is the question? What do you infer about speaking with others from this poem? So from this poem we understand that at all levels there is problems and sadness. Okay, there's problems and sadness to everyone, but with kind and gentle words they can be overcome. Sadness to everyone, but with kind and gentle words they can be overcome. So this is the second question. Third question is, what are the disadvantages of speaking harshly? What are the disadvantages? The disadvantages of speaking harshly. Okay children, so this is a fourth question. So what are the disadvantages of speaking harshly? So speaking harshly to people will deprive us of all the good, all the good we do here. So it is far better to rule by love than fear. It's far better to rule by love than fear. Harsh speakers will have more enemies than friends. Okay children, this is the third answer. So what are the disadvantages of speaking harshly? Speaking harshly to people will deprive us of all the good we do here. It is far better to rule by love than fear. Harsh speakers will have more enemies than friends. So what are the disadvantages of speaking harshly? Speaking harshly to people will deprive us of all the good we do here. It is far better to rule by love than fear. Hard speakers will have more enemies than friends. Then fourth question, why does the poet tell us to speak gently, tell us to speak gently to young children, okay, children. So this is a fourth question. Okay, so once again I'll read it, children, all these three questions, and then we'll go to the fourth question. Okay, children, why should we speak gently? We should speak gently because soft and kind words leave a deep and lasting impression. So we can win people's hearts by love, and God too likes it and reward us for eternity. What do you infer about speaking with others from this poem? From this poem, we understand that at all levels there is problems and sadness to everyone, but with kind and gentle words they can be overcome. Third is, what are the disadvantages of speaking harshly? Speaking harshly to people will deprive us of all the good we do here. It is far better to rule by love than fear. Harsh speakers will have more enemies than friends. Okay, children, so these are the three questions. So learn well. So just once again, I'll read it out. Read along with me when I'm reading, children. Why should we speak gently? We should speak gently because soft and kind words leave a deep and lasting impression. We can win people's hearts by love, and God too likes it and reward us for eternity. What do you infer about speaking with others from this poem? From this poem, we understand that at all levels there is problems and sadness to everyone, but with kind and gentle words they can be overcome. And the third question, what are the disadvantages of speaking harshly? Speaking harshly to people will deprive us of all the good we do here. It is far better to rule by love than fear. So harsh speakers will have more enemies than friends. Now we'll go to the fourth question now. Why does the poet tell us to speak gently to young children? So the answer is, so till here we have finished, children, these three questions. I've read the answer. Now we'll go to the fourth answer now. So now, fourth answer is, When we speak gently, to young children, they will learn to speak gently. Okay, children, the next point is, childhood period does not remain long remain long. So we should teach children. So we should teach children. So we should teach children softly and mildly. Softly and mildly. Okay, children. We can get there. We can get there. We can get there. Love. We can get there. Love and trust only. Love and trust only with kind words. Okay, children. With kind words. Do you understand this answer, children, now? So what's the fourth question? Why does the poet tell us to speak gently to young children? When we speak gently to young children, they will learn to speak gently. Childhood period does not remain long. Childhood period does not remain long. So we should teach children softly and mildly. We can get their love and trust only with kind words. Okay, children. So when we speak gently to young children, they will learn to speak gently. Childhood period does not remain long. So we should teach children softly and mildly. We can get their love and trust only with kind words. Okay, children. Next, we'll go to the fifth question. How should you speak with old people? How should you speak with old people? Okay, children. So for this answer is, so this is the last answer for y'all. We should use kind. We should use kind, gentle, loving, kind, gentle, loving, and caring words, and caring words, caring words with the old people, with the old people, because the old people, because their days are numbered, their days are numbered. Okay, children. Harsh words will, harsh words will make them sad, will make them sad. Harsh words will make them sad, but gentle words will, but gentle words will keep them happy, will keep them happy, will keep them happy, and they will die in peace, and they will die in peace. Okay, children, so this was the last question over this for you. So once again I'll read. How should you speak with old people? We should use kind, gentle, loving and caring words with the old people, because their days are numbered. Harsh words will make them sad, but gentle words will keep them happy, and they will die in peace. Children, fourth one I'll read out. Why does the poet tell us to speak gently to young children? That is, when we speak gently to young children, they will learn to speak gently. Childhood period does not remain long, so we should teach children softly and mildly. We can get their love and trust only with kind words. And the last question, how should you speak with old people? We should use kind, gentle, loving and caring words with the old people because their days are numbered. Harsh words will make them sad, but gentle words will keep them happy and they will die in peace. Okay, children? So by this we are finishing this poem, question answers. Thank you, children.